My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there is one goal that each and every object of creation strives to achieve throughout its existence. Whether that object be animal or man, jinn or ins, male or female, Muslim or kafir, it doesn't matter. It is but one goal. That is the ultimate goal of each and every object of creation. And it is the same goal. And that is the goal of happiness, of tranquility, serenity, peace. This is what each and every object of existence, each and every human being, Muslim or kafir, wishes to achieve. And you find that every act of his throughout the day and night is aimed towards this goal. What will make me happier? What will make me self-content? What will make me arrive at an inner feeling of tranquility and peace? Yet, if we were to ask the people who have achieved the heights in these respective fields, the richest, the most powerful, the most fortunate, the most recognized and famous people, if we were to ask those whom the average person of society looks up to as having reached the height of these respective ladders, we ask them, have you finally arrived at this happiness? You have spent 15, 20, 30, 40 years collecting money, becoming powerful, becoming famous. Have you arrived? Do you feel this tranquility that you were seeking for the last few decades? And if they were honest with you, if they were honest with you, then not one of them could truthfully respond, yes, we have arrived at this destination. Each one will say, no, it is yet to come. I need more money. I need to be more powerful. I need to be more famous. Not yet. But you don't even have to ask them. Statistics speak louder than their words. Do you know that the highest suicide rates in any society are not found amongst the poor, are not found amongst the people who are unknown and not famous? They are always the highest amongst the rich and the elite of society. Divorce rates, their run-ins with the law, drug problems, rehabilitation problems, they are always rampant in the rich and elite of society. Those whom others think have reached the heights, and yet in reality, they are far worse off than they were when they started their journey to come to the top. So the question arises, my dear brothers and sisters, what then is the road to spiritual happiness? How can a person arrive at this tranquility that is sought by all of the creation? Let us turn to the Quran and Sunnah. Let us see what Allah and His Messenger have to say about this topic. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe. O you who believe, this is verse directed to me and you, pay attention to it. O you who believe, Istajibu lillahi walil rasul, respond to the call of Allah and His Messenger. Idha da'akum lima yuhyikum, when they call you to that which will give you your life, to that which will give you the life that you seek. So Allah is saying, when you respond to the call of Allah and His Messenger, when you obey whatever Allah tells you to do, whatever the Prophet ﷺ tells you to do, in this is your life. In this is where you will feel the life that you desire. Allah says in the Quran, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ. Give the example of the one who was dead and we resurrected and brought him back to life. The reference here is not to a physically dead person. The reference here is to a person who is not worshipping Allah. And then Allah guided him to start worshipping Him. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us the path to happiness. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. He who does good, whether he is male or female, man or woman, and he has iman, then of a certainty, we are going to give him hayatan tayyiba, a sweet life, a beautiful life, a tranquil life. You ask, how can I live a good life in this world before the hereafter? How can I avoid the troubles and the worries of this dunya? Listen to the Quran. He who does good and he has iman, whether he is male or female, then of a certainty he will be given a sweet life, a beautiful life, a good life. In this world, of course the hereafter. But even in this world, the mu'min will be granted a life unlike that of the kafir and the non-Muslim. And yet another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. He who believes and gives of his money and does good, فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى, we will make things easy for him. We will make things easy for him. Meaning that no job will he take except that Allah will bless him in that job. No money will he earn except that Allah will give him all that he wants of that money. Barakah in that money. His marriage will be a success. His children will be a comfort to the eyes. His dunya and akhirah will be guaranteed. Everything will be made easy for him. As Allah Azza wa Jal says, he who gives and does good, everything will be made easy for him. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. As for him who was miserly, who was stingy with his money, and he thought that he had no need to worship Allah. Istaghna over here means he had no need for religion. I don't have time to pray. He has no need to worship Allah Azza wa Jal, and he denies the hereafter. Then فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى, we will make everything difficult for him. Everything. He might have the biggest bank account, but in his heart he will be the poorest person. He might drive the largest car, live in the fanciest of mansions, but inside of him will be a living hell, a jahim inside of him. His money and wealth will only cause more grief rather than bring him comfort and blessings. Everything will be made difficult for him because he has disbelieved in Allah. He has refused to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. My dear brothers and sisters, let us ponder over the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When a problem used to afflict him, what would he do? Where would he turn to? When a problem afflicts us, what do we do, my dear brothers and sisters? If we've had a difficult day at work, many of us come home and we turn the television on because we think that that difficulty will go away. It will drown away with the television. Or we might turn to other things, social talk, backbiting, visiting other people. Things which might be halal, might be makruh, might be haram. What did the Prophet ﷺ used to turn to after facing a problem, an adversary? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Aisha narrates, any time he was concerned about something, فَزِعَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ, he would rush to stand up in prayer. Prayer, salah. And that is why he would say, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال, O Bilal, hurry up, we want to taste the comfort of the prayer. أَرِحْنَا بِهَا, we want to taste the sweetness of the prayer. Why are you delaying? Say the iqama. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, جُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ, verily, the sweetness of my eyes, the comfort of this world to me has been made in the prayer. This is how I attain the tranquility that I need. There is one verse in the Quran, in fact half of a verse, which summarizes every single thing that I have said today. Everything. And this half verse consists of five words. Five words succinctly summarize all of this. Allah Azza wa Jal says, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. أَلَا is a word that is used to draw attention. Pay attention, something important is about to follow. بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, only through the remembrance of Allah, تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ, will the hearts attain tranquility. Only through the remembrance of Allah, only through the worship of Allah, only by turning to Allah Azza wa Jal, will we face, will we attain, will we come to the destination that is eternally besought of all of mankind, that of happiness. Ala bi dhikri llahi tatma'innul qulub. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-'azima li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al-muslimin min kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim.